Hello, my name is Chris Ullman. I'm an environmental health practitioner for Fargo-Cass Public Health. I'm here today to talk to you about cleaning and disinfecting your classroom. Let's start by explaining the difference between the two. Normal cleaning with soap and water removes germs and dirt from surfaces. This can help lower the risk of spreading COVID-19. Disinfectants kill germs on surfaces. By killing the germs on a surface after cleaning, you are lowering the risk of spreading the virus that much more. When disinfecting, it is important that you use an EPA-approved chemical. You may already have disinfectants available in the building, so it's important that you talk with maintenance staff to see if this option is available. If not, you can always make your own. A simple disinfection recipe is to add 1/3 cup of bleach to 1 gallon of water. It is important that you protect yourself whether cleaning or disinfecting and wear proper personal protective equipment. Glove use when using any chemicals is strongly recommended. Ensure that after disinfectant is used, that it is properly stored somewhere children are not able to get their hands on it. Surfaces identified as not commonly shared or high touch can be cleaned. High touch surfaces are recommended to be cleaned and disinfected to help mitigate the spread of the virus. These include tables, doorknobs, light switches, phones, shared keyboards, faucets, sinks, and shared touch screens. Each classroom may have a different high touch object, so it is important to identify those and disinfect appropriately. The proper procedure is to clean first with soap and water and disinfect after. It is important when using a disinfectant to either use a single-use paper towel or to store the wiping cloth used for disinfection in the disinfectant for future use. Thank you for your time.